Hey guys, my name's Brandon, also known as GreenCobrasGaming, and here, well, I was supposed to do a discussion with PancakeArmorman, late gear to you, and the TheJamesRolls doing the final Smash Direct, anything. I couldn't make it, so I'm doing my own questions by myself and everything. So here we go. Let's start with the first question. And the first question that he asked was, without mentioning anything that happened during the direct, what were you expecting going into it? Well, the things I was expecting to see is I thought there were going to be more characters be announced. Like, I thought they were going to, than, you know, a few. Like, I thought they're going to be, like, more characters than, you know, what we got. Which, I mean, and everything. And also, I was hoping to have an adventure mode. Like, you know, from the subspace emissary from Brawl. Yeah, Brawl, Smash Brothers Brawl and everything. So I was hoping for that, and we did get that, so that's good. I thought it's gonna be like a lot bigger because the final Smash, so it had to go out big, but they really didn't go out that big. I thought they would go out a lot bigger, like character and everything, but no, they only announced a few characters, which kind of disappointing. I thought, you know, we do have a ton of characters. Like, we have gonna have, but including with the DLC, we're gonna have like 80 characters. So like, wow, which is still insane. But like, the amount of characters that were announced is kind of disappointing. That's the thing. Like, still a lot of characters that we play as, but the amount, which at least we got some characters and everything that was announced and everything. But yeah, I was kind of expecting the sort of hopefully the adventure mode and like more characters. I wasn't expecting. I guess maybe announce some of the stages, maybe like new stages. But and like I said that new feature that they had, which end up being what I wanted, like with the adventure mode and everything. But anyway, let's go on to the next question. What are your thoughts on Ken and the Cinema War? Well, the thing is, you had the leaks with the Grinch, and I know Incendiary War came true. Like, I know that, but I think that was the only one from the Grinch. I really didn't really look at those leaks. Like, I heard about it just from Twitter and people posting about it, and I just think the whole leak thing is just was dumb. Like, I don't know how they got, like, Grinch has to do with anything with Smash Brothers, but yeah, the whole thing, like, I don't know why, like, oh, the Grinch leaked Smash Brothers, blah, 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 blah. Oh, who fucking cares? Like, what, don't, like, okay, it's not even that funny. Like, it's not even funny. Like, what? But anyway, yeah, like, I know Incendiary War was one of those leaks which actually came to, which, I mean, I really don't really care that much. Like said, like, I mean, while like Incineroar is pretty cool Pokemon, is that like, and it's nice to see more Pokemon, but it's not really excited that much for Incineroar. Like, yeah. I mean, we already have Lucario, we have Greninja, yeah. So, and then also Ken, like, I really haven't played some, like, Street Fighter, really. I mean, I guess I have played a Street Fighter game or so, like, but not, like, actually play one where I, like, played a ton of. I guess I played, like, one with friends before, and actually I do own, I guess, Street Fighter Ultimate 2, I believe. Street Fighter 2 Ultimate, that's the thing it was called, and I played a little bit of it, and so I just, not the biggest fan of the controls in that game, but. And it could be because I just suck at fighting games, but like that's really cool that we got another Street Fighter character. That's pretty cool. I believe that's only two Street Fighter characters so far, like everything. So that's cool that we have more of that. But like the Pokemon is like. Kind of already have these type, like, we already have a bunch of fighting, which, I mean, it makes sense because it's Smash Brothers. You gotta have, it makes sense to have fighting type Pokemon when it's Smash Brothers, so. Wait, no, wait, Cinnamon's not fighting type. Cinnamon's not fighting type, in mind. Cinnamon's dark fire, that's what it is. I guess it just looks like it's a fighting type, but it's not a fighting type. Anyway, Cinnamon is fire dark. My bad. Yeah, I even played Sun and Moon. I should know this. Like, I picked that starter in Sun and Moon, in my original Sun and Moon. So, like, well, I played Moon. I played Moon version, but yeah. And now let's go on the next question. What are your thoughts on Spirits mode? Well, at first, when I saw it, like, this... when they first showed it on the main menu for Spirits, I was really disappointing because I thought it was gonna be adventure mode. I was hoping for adventure and everything, and it was kind of disappointing. But then later near the end, they showed the adventure mode with the spirits and everything. So I was like, "Whoa, okay, never mind." And this is that pretty cool. Which I mean, it's still a pretty cool feature. Like even without the adventure mode, with having you know, like spirits help the character, like, power boost or whatever, it is thingy-bajig. That's really nice to see and everything. That's a pretty cool feature, but it would have been a lot more disappointing if there was no adventure mode, and if it were just that, if it was just them helping, that would have been really disappointing. It's like, because, like, I was, like, watching, it's like, really, that's it? That's the other mode? We don't even have adventure mode? And then when they show up at the very end, like, yes, fine, okay, they're waiting to land for that, okay. Which, I mean, it makes sense because adventure mode in Smash Brothers Brawl is great. I mean, it's the reason why I love Brawl. Like, Brawl is my favorite because of that. And also has a good character. Like, I think we have at a point where we have so many characters. Like, it's more of, like, what features they add, like the adventure mode, for example. Like, even like in Brawl, like Brawl has still have a good amount of characters, even though it doesn't have every character, it has a good amount of characters. So, and now Ultimate has every character, which makes it better when having everything, and plus new characters. But yeah, but anyway, now let's go on next question. What do you think of this game's lineup of assist trophies? I mean, some of them cool. Like, I haven't really looked into much of the assist trophies. I saw some of them. I mean, it's a cool idea. I mean, I definitely can see some of the characters could have been their own character instead of assist trophy, but as well, some of them could be Echo Fighters, which also, speaking of which, Echo Fighters, I want to add, like, to this, with the Echo Fighters, I thought there'd be more Echo Fighters. Like, it doesn't seem like we have that many Echo Fighters. I mean, we have some, but not many. I thought there'd be more Echo Fighters. I had to look how many we have. I don't know exactly how many we have exactly on top of my head, but I'm pretty sure we don't have that as many. I guess they do count Echo Fighters as like the 80 of the 80 fighters. They include Echo Fighters, so I thought there would be more Echo Fighters actually. And maybe there'll be. Of course, maybe there might be part of the DLC. I don't know. But yeah, like, but of the assist trophies, I mean, that's cool. The assist. I mean, it's a lot. I feel like it's similar to Spirits mode a little bit. Or the spirits a little bit, but I guess you just, like, I guess in spirit mode, you just have the power. It's like, I guess assist trophies are like spirits, but it's a separate, like, character that's helping you out. Like, assist trophies is, like, a character that's helping you out instead of, you know, having it. While in spirit mode, you have, you play, still, like, so for example, you still play a Sonic, but say if you have a spirit of the thinking of spirit. I can't think. Okay, whatever. I'm thinking. I can't think off the top of my head, but whatever. Well, yeah, what I'm trying to say is the. Anyway, I'm just gonna move on. anyway, what's the next question? Piranha Plant is apparently a thing now. What are your thoughts? Well. I was actually shocked. Like, what? Like, okay. Like, that's interesting. It's also interesting how, like, you had to, like, you know, hook up your account. It's only limited time. I guess it's not a pre-order thing. Well, sort of is a pre-order, but not a pre-order. Like, it is and is not. Like, it's not because, you know, it can still get it after the game comes out. But it's a limited time. I guess it's just a limited time thing that you can get, that you had to get, and you had to hook up your account to the My Nintendo thingy, or account, whatever source thing they have. and try to get Pip Prime, which is interesting. Which I don't know why they did it that way. And also, of all the characters, why did they do Piranha Plant? That was so unexpected. And also, I can see Piranha Plant being like really like a lot of people don't like, because like it's just so random. Like what? But at the same time, it's like it'd be interesting to play as. Might be fun. I don't know. I haven't played it. I mean, the game's not out yet, so I don't know. But also, I can see Prom Plant being a meme, like a big meme. But anyway, let's go to the next question. Without discussing special cases, what are your thoughts on the DLC plans announced? Without discussing what characters I want. Well, it's nice to have like DLC characters and everything. I mean, it's not much. I believe it was $5 or $6. I think it was $6. But anyway, James Rolls can put a text on screen saying what it actually was. hopefully he sees this whole video and likes and actually does it. It'd be great. Do it. But yeah, like, I'm gonna like discuss what characters I want anyway, like, cause it says discuss without specific characters, so like we don't even know anything about the DLCs besides how many they are. Like that's all. Like I'm hoping to see characters like Banjo-Kazooie, that was part of the Grinch. Which might not make it, cool, but at the same time, they're owned by Microsoft, so I doubt it. I doubt that's gonna happen, but you never know. I mean, they do got Solid Snake, or Snake, and everything, Sonic, and all that, so I'd be surprised. So I believe that would be hard to do. Like, I think it would be easier, to get characters that are multi-platformed. Like, for example, Spyro and Crash, I think would be easier to get than Banjo-Kazooie, and because they're multi-platformed games, while Banjo-Kazooie is currently owned by Microsoft, which Microsoft owns Rare now, so really Xbox Microsoft exclusive, really, I guess, property, not really Xbox exclusive, but Microsoft group, because they can put it on PC if they want, but I can see Spyro and Crash being a lot easier because they're owned by Activision, so they can be multi-platform. So hopefully they come to DLC, maybe that'd be cool. And then there's another character that I would love, even though I highly doubt it, very highly doubt it, is like Lara Croft. But I can see her being more in like a Smash, in a PlayStation Smash Brothers, even though she wasn't. Yeah, that's the weird thing. They have there's a PlayStation PS3 called PlayStation All-Stars and everything, with a bunch of like PlayStation characters fighting, which is pretty much the Sony's version of Smash Brothers, which is not near as good and just cool, is kind of weird. And just, I think it's just playing on PlayStation is just weird, like with the controls and everything. Just, I mean, I can see why they're trying to do that, because Smash Bros. Is just, so why not we try that? But I don't think it did that well. So I mean, I think it did alright. I think game, but I don't think it sold that well, because the controls are not well, and people would rather play Smash Brothers because Smash Brothers, come on. And also, it lacked some characters, very big characters, it had no Crash, no Spyro, no Lara Croft. The weird thing is, it had Sly Cooper and Jack and Daxter and everything, and all those, and Ratchet and Clank, but I do feel like the Jack and Daxter from the PlayStation All-Stars and Sly Cooper, are both kind of underrated games nowadays. Like, Jack and Daxter is still pretty popular, though. Jack and Daxter is pretty popular, but because when you think of a Naruto game, most people think of Uncharted or The Last of Us. And if neither of that, they think of Crash. because that's where they start. And like, because Jak and Daxter is kind of the middle ground and everything. And Jak and Daxter is my favorite Naughty Dog game, so. And I think it's a lot better than Uncharted and The Last of Us. Actually, I think Jak and Daxter is my favorite, and then Crash, and then one of those other. Which I have, of course, I don't have that much experience with The Last of Us or Uncharted. Jeez, took me that long. Uncharted, but yeah, like, and then Sly Cooper was like the least known one of the big PS3. Big PS2. Sorry, not PS3, big PS2 mascots. Like, because you had Crash. No, you didn't have Crash. PS1, sorry. You had Spyro. No, Spyro's PS1. Jeez. You had Ratchet and Clank, Jak and Daxter, and Sly Cooper. And Sly Cooper's the least known, even though Sly Cooper's the best of the three. And pretty much anyone that he hasn't played it, and then they play it, they love it. Like, that's what I hear all the time. Like, people who haven't played it, but then they play it, they absolutely love Sly Cooper. So, like, that's the intro. That's what I find interesting. Like, I've seen people who said this is the first time playing, and they love it. Which is good. Which, I mean, because it's a good series, a good game. Well, not just a good game, but a good series as an all. Fourth one's not as good, but yeah. But that's really interesting and everything that happens and everything. But, like, oh, and, like, but yeah. Oh, also, another character I would love, which is also, I guess, also a PlayStation mascot. Even though I think they've been on Nintendo console, I think, on the 3DS. And they're also coming for, and their new game is also coming for the Xbox One, so. Which is Kingdom Hearts 3, with the Sora, obviously. I want Sora for Smash Bros. That'd be awesome. So that'd be awesome if Sora comes for Smash Bros. God, imagine if Sora came for Smash Bros. As DLC. That would be all pretty cool. Like, Sora from Kingdom Hearts. And like I said, it's been on a 3DS. It's been on 3DS, so. And it's like I said, the third game is coming for Xbox One, which, if it doesn't come for the Switch, if Kingdom Hearts 3 doesn't come for Switch, I'm going to get the Xbox One version. So, yeah. If it doesn't. At least I can play it if I can. Of course, I probably still need to beat the first two, but. But, yeah. So, those are the kind of kids I want, really. Maybe see more stages as well. Like, I think it said there was one stage. Well, I think they have one stage, one character, and one something else. I had to look at it again. And there's like four, like, and there's like five DLCs and everything. So, like I said, $5-$6, like, whatever it is. But anyway, I'm done with talking about DLC because I talked about that for probably quite a bit of time. Well, actually, what is my time? I'm gonna check what my time is. Time is 17 minutes. Okay, this is not that long. I thought this was gonna be an hour. I mean, I guess because I'm not talking and not like and you know, the James Roll Pancake and all of them were not interrupting me at all, so it's nice that happened. But anyway, let's go on to the semi-final question. And the question is, what are your thoughts on the new adventure mode, World of Light? Well, the answer is simple. I'm so looking forward to this so much. Like, this could be the best Smash Brothers. Because it has the adventure mode. Come on, like, wait. This is the reason why Brawl is my favorite. Like, because the thing is with Smash Brothers is, like, the problem with Smash 4 is it didn't have adventure mode and everything. So, like, it's kind of boring. The single player content in 4 was kind of boring, like, and everything. And, like, this time we want to play Smash Brothers but you don't have any friends to play with currently. Which, I mean, there's online, but still. But, and also not really much competitively anyway. I'm like, I don't play Smash Brothers competitively, and I'm not good at Smash Brothers. Like, I'll get beaten unless I play with, like, friends or whatever. And even then, some of them are pretty good. Like, some of them are pretty good. But not as good as probably the people who play online, but, you know, because they're closer to my rank. And everything, so yeah, like, I'm so excited. Like, that's the thing with, like, the Smash Brothers, like, it's that's the problem with I hate about all, like, a lot of games that, like, don't, like, they're getting rid of the single player experience. Like, really? Like, really? I mean, I get there's some games that really don't need it because you know, the campaigns would suck either way. Like, for example, Call of Duty, like, who plays Call of Duty single player? Plus, I mean, it sucks anyway. Plus, COD sucks anyway. I mean, COD sucks either way. Even without the single player, it still sucks. And because, like, just because Well, mainly because, you know, it's the same game after same game after same game after same game for, like, the past 15 years. God, yeah, that's just pathetic. But yeah, but I still don't like games that don't, like, games that aren't like, I don't like games that are multiplayer only, or have a short, like, even if it, like, at least, I want, like, a game that actually has, a single player experience, like, you know, like, Spyro, Sly Cooper, Ratchet and Clank, all those fun games back in the day, even games like now, like, Skyrim, you know, that's, I guess that's 2011, but still, it's still recently newish, it's not new, but it's newish, because, like, 2011, so, like, of course, that's 7 years ago, so, it was quite a bit of long time ago, but yeah, like, I'm so excited for this new adventure mode, though. I'm like, oh my god. Also, the trailer for it was, like, the music for it was amazing. Like, oh my god, the music, like, because I think Nintendo knows how to do music, because you had, also had, like, a while ago when they first announced, well, I don't know if it when they first announced it. I think it probably was when they first announced it. Well, at least they showed the trailer of it, was of the new Mario game, of Super Mario Odyssey, like, during, I guess it was during a few E3s ago, because it's been out for over a year now, so. But yeah, like, Odyssey. I mean, that's a semi-decent game, even though I prefer Galaxies and Sunshine. And maybe 64 overall. I don't know. 64, I'm not the biggest fan either. But I love Sunshine and I love the Two Galaxy games, so. But I mean, I'm not saying, I mean, Odyssey is a really good game. I mean, while Odyssey is a pretty good game too, but it's just, I don't think open world really works with Mario. That's just my opinion, you know. Open world really doesn't work with Mario. And I mean, as in, like, which I know Sunshine, they count as open world, but my definition of Sunshine being open world is not, I mean, it's not open world to me. Like, Sunshine is not open world. Like, when I mean open world, I mean Skyrim, Breath of the Wild, open world. Just letting you know. That, by the way. Yeah, so, yeah. Because I guess the thing is, it all depends what, like, what's your definition of open world. So, to me, Sunshine's and 64 are not open world games. But Odyssey is, so. Yeah, Odyssey is totally open world. And I don't think it really works that well. And also, collecting so many moons and everything, it's like, just kind of boring. I'm just saying, kind of boring. Well, Breath of the Wild, it works, because it's Zelda. Like, I think it works really well. Zelda works really well, and it's the type of game that would look really well. Like, it is a type of game. Like, even if it's, even, take a different game that's similar to Zelda, for example, it works. Like, that would, yeah. But anyway, I know I kind of distracting from the discussion, but yeah, like, the new adventure mode is going to be awesome. Like I said, I love the music. I'm so excited. I do interesting how well it's going to be compared to how long and how well it's going to be compared to Brawl. And it's interesting because I know in Brawl near the end, it took a while near the end because you had the big maze that took a while. Of course, it wasn't that long of a campaign wall, but the maze took a long time though. So, but yeah, but I'm excited for it. And it's interesting to see, especially going to the different. Oh yeah, because it's definitely like different worlds of Smash Brothers. Like different, like you can go to, like, I think it showed you going to like Kanto even or something like that. And everything, just the different world, like the Pokemon world, you got the Mario Party world, you got the even probably Earthbound world or something like that, something crazy like that. And I know Legia to you and Pancake would really love that, and they also would really love if, you know, if Mother 3 comes. You know, I know they're good games. I need to play them. I mean, just I think just I guess because the first thing I. To be fair, the first time I ever heard of, like, Earthbound was Smash 3. Or Smash Brawl. Smash Brothers Brawl. Smash 3. Smash 3 of them. 1, 2, 3. Anyway, we're smashing 5 now. Because Smash 5. Or Smash Brothers Ultimate. The Ultimate Smash. Okay, I'm just kidding. But anyway. Final thoughts before we wrap up this discussion? Well, I pretty much said all. Like, I'm pretty much the last question. I'm kind of just wrapping this up. Like I said, I was kind of like, it was kind of a little disappointing discussion. I mean, the adventure mode did help quite a bit. Like, it did. Like, because I thought there would be, like, so I thought there were going to be a lot more characters announced. Which, I mean, I guess they're waiting for DLC, which I guess that's part of me. Like, but the thing is, we don't know what the DLC characters are, because they could be none of the characters that we want. Like, they might not be, but they might be not Spyro. There's no Spyro, no Crash, no Banjo-Kazooie, no Sora, no whoever else you want. Goku, I don't know. I'm joking. Goku. Yeah, I've seen people done that. People who's like, oh, I want Goku for Smash, but like, God, no. Why? That's why wouldn't they do that? It's not even a video game character. like Goku's not even a video game character. Come on. And I haven't even seen the Dragon Balls anyway. The Dragon Balls. Or like different like the 5 different series I have of just that of the past like 30 years, something like that. But yeah. I bet that would be interesting if that was actually true. But yeah. I am really excited for it. I am really excited for this game. Like, I think this will be better than 4. Not sure about it. Probably will be better than Brawl. Just, I think this will be my favorite because it has all the characters and it has adventure mode. So, and this is gonna be awesome. So, yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Like, also Prawn Plant. I'm probably gonna get Prawn Plant and try it out and just see, like. That'd be interesting to do. But anyway, I see you guys then for another discussion, maybe sometime in the future, or even maybe when, or maybe even later when Lega TV eventually, gets the Sonic Generations of our Versus up on game eventually, but he's kind of busy with, moving in and stuff and switching places and everything. So yeah. But anyway, I've been Green Coach Gaming, and there have been. Oh, right, I was doing it by myself. So anyway, I've been Green Coach Gaming. Bye.